Welcome to Wednesday Healing Sessions here at Victory Life Centre. I have Pastor Barbara Oldfield with me and I'm Marika Court. And we're here to talk about Pentecost Sunday that's coming up this Sunday and the move of the Holy Ghost that's about to happen in our city, in our nation and around the world because God is pouring His Spirit out. And you know, Pentecost Sunday is where the Holy Spirit invaded the church. The disciples of Jesus were touched dramatically. The wind blew from heaven and tongues of fire sat upon them. It says in Acts 2:4, and they were all filled with the Holy Ghost and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. And you know, that tongues, that Holy Ghost that filled their spirit and, you know, flows out of their heart when they began to pray in the Holy Ghost, that has impacted the whole church around the world. Today we're going to talk about that a little bit and the power behind it. And you know, the power behind it, Barbara, because in the Word of God it says, the Spirit helpeth our infirmities.
Amen. I just love Pentecost Sunday was the day the church was birthed. That's the first day of the New Testament church, the day of Pentecost had come. And it was a promise in Acts 1:8, Jesus told the disciples, He said, tarry, wait for the promise of the Father. And I love it. And He said, and you shall be my witnesses. After this power comes, you will testify and show the world what happened on this day. And I love that, that was the day the church was birthed in the upper room with those who decided, I believe there would have been 500 there to begin with.
Yeah.
But after the days went by, I think some of them may have left.
Yeah.
And it was only poured out on those who were willing to wait for the promise of the Spirit. And how amazing.
Yeah,
what an amazing
they gave us
day.
The Holy Ghost, and He's our comforter, He's our helper, He's our teacher, and He's with us all the time. He's never going to leave us, He's never going to forsake us, and He's always there with us no matter what. And also, if we go on to Acts 2:17, because we're in the last days now, and it says, and it shall come to pass in the last days, says God, that I'll pour out my Spirit on all flesh. Your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, your young men shall see visions, your old men shall dream dreams, and on my maidservants and men servants, I will pour out my Spirit in those days, and they shall prophesy. You know what? That's these days. That's right now, Pastor Barb, isn't
Absolutely.
It?
Absolutely. This is the day, and this is coming to pass right in our time. And it's what was prophesied by the prophet Joel, you know, that I will pour out my Spirit on all flesh. Yeah. And so I just think that's wonderful. And I was thinking about today, we don't have to wait like they did for 10 days in an upper room.
Yeah.
The day people invite Jesus into their heart, they can experience their own Pentecost. Like Jesus comes in, the Spirit is recreated. To receive the Holy Spirit, they become a holy temple. They become a place where the Spirit of God can come freely and take up residence within them.
I know.
And I love the fact that the sign that they were filled with the Spirit was they began to speak with another tongue.
Oh, yeah.
This is quite incredible. It's a sign that you have been filled with the Holy Spirit. And I identify with that. That was one of the reasons I knew I was saved. I'm not the sort of person to pretend or make believe. But the fact that after I received Jesus, I was instantly baptized with the Holy Ghost, I began to speak with a new tongue.
Yeah.
I wasn't taught about it. I just got up and this supernatural language came out of my mouth. And I knew it was powerful. And it was not something I really knew much about, but it was a sign that indeed the Holy Spirit had come and indwelt me.
Yeah.
And I knew there was something different, just like they must have felt on that day, Marika.
Well, I actually grew up in church and then I walked away from God when I was about 16, 17. But when I was growing up in church, I don't think praying in tongues really meant that much to me because I hadn't made that decision. But it wasn't till I gave my heart back to the Lord and I was in a desperate situation when I was about 23 on my knees going, God, help me.
Please, yes.
That I really, really felt the power of God and I was able to pray in the Holy Ghost and I felt His presence and His anointing. Mm-hmm. And maybe, yes, it happened a little bit when I was younger, but not like when I really, truly made that decision and gave my heart to the Lord for myself when I was 23.
Amen.
That the power of God touched me. And my tongue was so much freer because when I was younger, I got stuck on this tongue for years.
Yes.
Like shunami, konami, runami, konami. I can still remember what it was. And I couldn't get past that. And it was like there was a blockage. But when I made that choice and that decision for myself in a desperate situation, I gave my heart back to the Lord, is really when the power of God touched me and the Holy Ghost flowed out of me. So I really believe in many ways it's a heart choice. It's a heart decision when we say, Holy Spirit, come
help.
In. Have your way. Come and help me. You're my comforter. And you make that decision, it will flow out of you. And it's with
Definitely.
Our heart. It's with
Definitely.
Our heart.
And I think when we speak in tongues, we've got to be aware that it's a manifestation of His presence. And it's for our benefit.
Yeah.
That if we pray in the Spirit, and we're going to talk about that in Romans 8:26.
Yeah.
It says, if we don't know what to pray for, He does.
Yeah.
And what's it talking about? The He is the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
The absolute wisdom of God is there, the presence, the power, the purity of God is there, available for us.
Yeah.
And it says when we don't know what to pray for, He does.
Yeah.
So as we pray in the Spirit, we may be speaking mysteries, like we think it's a mystery.
Yeah.
But it's not a mystery.
Yeah.
It's the wisdom of God that we are speaking into the situation.
Yeah.
And we don't have to understand necessarily what it is, but we are speaking and understanding that God is giving us the utterance.
Yeah.
And you know, like in Acts 2:4, and when the day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all with one accord.
Yeah.
And the Spirit of God moved on them and gave them the utterance.
Yeah.
And so as we, what's our part? We pray.
Yeah.
It's not, we have to pray. Mm-hmm. And some people say, I don't know what to pray. Well, pray in the Spirit. You are actually praying what you need to be praying.
Well, especially when you get a doctor's report.
Oh.
That, you know, the doctors say, oh, you know, you're going to have this for the rest of your life. It says in the Word of God that the Spirit helpeth your infirmities.
Mm.
So when you're praying in the Holy Ghost, it's bringing life to your body. And I love what it says in Romans 8 here. It says, yes, God raised Jesus to life. And since God's Spirit of resurrection lives in you, He will also raise your dying body to life by the same Spirit that breathes life into you. That's in the Passion Translation.
Wow.
And it says that He will also raise your dying body to life by the same Spirit that breathes life in you. And, you know, that's no matter what, all sickness is one step, you know, towards people dying. The enemy's trying to kill off God's people. He's trying to kill off anyone who does anything good in the world. He's
Definitely.
A liar. He's a, you know, he's out to kill, steal and destroy. And, you know, he wants to people to die young. And we know all that. But the enemy's plans and strategies are put to stop when we know the power of the name of Jesus, the power of the Word of God, and begin to pray in the Holy Ghost, because it says it brings life and breathes life into your body.
Mortal, yeah.
It brings life.
I love that. This is the scripture I stood on when I had breast cancer. Your mum came by and she said, what scripture are you standing on? And I'll never forget this scripture. Because it says, but, and you've read it from the Passion, but if I read it from the New King James, but if the Spirit of Him who raised Jesus from the dead dwells in you, He who raised Christ from the dead will also give life to your mortal body through the Spirit, the life-giving Spirit that lives in you.
Yeah.
And I was thinking about that we carry the Spirit of God. We carry the life of God, the health of God, the peace of God. And it's imparted to us with our knowledge, our awareness that the same Spirit that raised Christ from the dead lives in
me.
Yeah. Therefore, that same Spirit can raise me up out of any sickness, any disease, any infirmity.
Yeah.
And that's the belief what we must have, because if the Holy Spirit brought Jesus out of death, he certainly can bring us out of any infirmity, sickness.
It's true.
It's true.
And it says there it breathes life. But I love in Ezekiel 37, I mean, I've been through this before, but I'm going to go through it again because I just love it when he begins to prophesy to the dry bones. And I really believe people, any person listening out there, you can prophesy to your situation because sickness is like a dry bone. And God's saying you can prophesy to it, prophesy, you know, life, prophesy breath. And it says here, indeed, I looked at the sinews and the flesh came upon them and the skin covered them, but there was no breath in them. Also, he said to me, prophesy to the breath. There it says that word breath again, like in Romans 8:11. Prophesy, son of man, and say to this breath, thus says the Lord God, come from the four winds, O breathe and breathe on the slain that they may live. Amen. Now, God is wanting to breathe life into this earth today. He's wanting to breathe his life into people's bodies, into their minds, into their situations. And we need to begin to speak life and declare life. Thank you, Jesus. My blood or my kidneys or my liver or my your bones. Heart or your bones. Thank you, Father, that your breath and your life flow through my body and make alive my mortal flesh. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. And you can begin to prophesy exactly those words, exactly like that, and begin to prophesy life into your situation. Because the doctors have spoken death, usually.
Absolutely.
And, you know, the enemy comes with thoughts of death.
Yes.
And it comes against our minds. And then you begin to, oh, that knee, oh, you know, it's getting worse. No, you need to begin to declare life. Thank you, Jesus, that your life flows through my knee.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus, that your life flows through every joint, every tissue. You can lay your own hands on your knee and begin to declare and prophesy life into your knee or into your body. And no matter what the situation, God is going to turn it all around for good because he's a God of love and mercy and compassion. And he loves us so much.
I think
he wants us to walk in divine health.
We've got to know that Jesus, you know, and
God loves our knees.
Jesus sent us the Holy Spirit. He said, when I go away, it's better for you that I go away so the Holy Spirit can come.
Yep.
Because if I do not go, he will not come. And so
it's true.
It's so important to understand. But the Holy Spirit was sent to the earth as a helper, you know, in John 15, 26. And he said, I will send you a helper.
Yeah.
And that word is parakletos, another one just like me.
Yeah.
Exactly. Just like me. And the word is, I will send you a helper. And that word helper, when you read about it, it says he'll be your comfort, your advisor, your advocate, your strengthener, your standby, your helper, intercessor. He will be everything to you.
Yeah.
So he will be your health.
Yes.
I tell people, I have the best immune system in the world.
Yeah.
And they ask me what it is. And I say, the risen, resurrected Christ by the Holy Spirit lives in me.
Yep.
That is my immune system.
Yeah.
Because that life-giving spirit is constantly at work in me doing what? Healing, strengthening, encouraging. How about wisdom when we don't know? And I was saying to you, Marika, earlier and to the viewers, I had 6 days once with a tooth that had a root nerve problem. And it was like I was plugged into electricity for 6 days. They packed my face in ice. They took four root nerves from four teeth, still did not change it. And one night I cried out. I said, Holy Spirit, you alone know which tooth is it? And would you believe? He said, it's the little tooth in the front. I said, thank you. I returned to the special. I said, last night I prayed and God said, it's the little tooth. Oh, he said, it can't be that one. I said, I'm desperate. Would you please just treat that one? Guess what? It was that tooth.
Yeah.
Instantly healed with wisdom from above.
Yeah. And he does that. Because I remember when
marvelous.
I had bulging discs in my back, I couldn't straighten my back up. I was in agony. I'm lying on bed going, Holy Spirit, what shall I do? And a lady at church walked up to me and she said, you need to go to an osteopath. And I went, I've never been... osteopath, what's that? And
what
then
does that mean?
I'm standing in a prayer meeting and I got the words osteopath. I said, that's that lady said that to me. As soon as I went to them, by the next day, bang.
Yes.
I was up and walking.
Yeah, God,
and I'd
been
to physio. God helps you and he shows you along the way.
Yes.
Sometimes he can use medical professionals. Sometimes it's just a complete straight out miracle.
Yes.
Sometimes it's just binding the devil. But the Holy Spirit shows us what to do, because all sickness is of the devil, and God wants us healed, because he'll use any which way to get you to walk in divine health. The best way is to lay hands and get completely healed, just like that. So we don't even need a dentist or an osteopath.
Well, I think the best thing is to stay in health.
Yes.
My declaration every day is I'm strong and I'm healthy, because I know I'm in Christ and Christ is in me. So if the resurrected Christ lives in me, he's quickening, healing, strengthening every day.
Yeah.
And because you're being led by the Spirit and directed by the Spirit, you don't find yourself going off track as much.
Yeah.
And ending up in a path where you're on the right path most of the time, not always, but you don't need that correction as much. You know, the Lord will say, no, you don't need to go there today. Stay home and do this. You go, have a rest today. So if you're led by the Spirit,
yeah,
there's a fair chance you're going to be led in those places where, you know, there's rest and recreation and, you know, just good times ahead.
Yes.
Not all the time.
Well, sometimes the Holy Spirit will just say to us, stay home and just worship me. And then the power of God hits you and whatever symptoms you had are just gone.
Yes.
Because it's under the power of God. And you know what? I've stood and worshipped at home before and just worshipped him. The power of God's hit me. And God's manipulated my back. He's literally...
Yes, he's your chiropractor.
Back just bending in a different way that I couldn't do myself. And he's like that. He can heal you at home. He'll do it any which way possible.
Yeah, I think it's just the prompt. You know, for some people to drink more than 2 cups of coffee a day is going to cause them problems, but not for everybody. But the Holy Spirit will reveal to you when you ask him, ask me, I'll show you things. And for some people, they can't eat certain foods or whatever. If they want to eat them, they could use their faith and believe. But what we're saying is the Holy Spirit has wisdom for you.
Yeah.
And that wisdom for you may not apply to somebody else.
Don't eat 5 jam donuts, just eat half
don't
of one.
Don't eat 5 jam donuts, definitely not. But and also, like, you know, it's just the wisdom that you need. So if we lack wisdom, what do we ask? We say, ask God.
Yeah.
He'll show us.
He does.
And it could be for somebody, forgive me. You know, you mean my healing is linked to forgiveness?
Yeah.
So I need to forgive?
Yeah.
And the Lord says, the minute you forgive and release it, you will release yourself health.
Yeah.
Because the hindrance, there's a toxin in your bloodstream.
Yeah.
It's hindering the healing. And Jesus said, if you do not forgive, you will not be forgiven.
Yeah.
And you know, forgiveness is synonymous with healing.
Yeah.
Salvation, healing. So
well, it says,
he might just hear, forgive.
Well, Mark 11, 23, 24, and it says in 24, therefore I say to you, whatsoever things you ask when you pray, believe that you receive them, and you will have them. And whenever you stand praying, if you have anything against anyone, forgive him, that your Father in heaven may also forgive your trespasses. So there's such a key. It's in the Word of God there.
It's a very big key.
Yeah, and forgiveness. And yeah, people do things that hurt, but we do need to let it go. And sometimes it's a process. Sometimes it is forgiving them every day until you get, you know, because it comes up every day because you're in the middle of it. And you've just got to let it go and hand it over to God and say, God, I've handed them over to you. Love that book. Take them to the courts of heaven. Hand it over to God.
You deal with it.
Yep. God deals with it.
See, if we release people from the debt they owe us, they may have robbed my parents, took my childhood. I had been abused, I've been rejected, I've been wounded, I've been all of those things, but they actually cannot pay that debt back. They can't give me back my childhood.
Mm.
So if you release people from the debt you feel they owe you, they mistreated you or whatever, just release them into the hands of God. Say, God, I release that to you. I'm trusting you. And then you don't put yourself in the hand of the enemy who can keep something on you because you've opened a door.
Yeah.
By not releasing it. So I just encourage you. People cannot sometimes pay you back a debt they owe you.
That's
but guess
true.
Who can?
God can.
God can restore.
Yeah.
Replenish.
He turns it all around for
you. Oh, I'm having my second childhood now. It's wonderful. I'm enjoying it much more than I did my first childhood.
Restoration is a massive key to being able to, you know, enjoy what the God's done for us, what Jesus did on the cross. Well, the Holy Spirit, when we begin to pray in the Holy Ghost, God begins to restore your body, your finances, every area, because you're tapping into the Holy Ghost and He begins to lead and guide you, and He'll bring all the restoration that you need in every single area.
Yes.
Spirit, soul, and body.
Yeah, three parts.
Yep.
You are a spirit, live in a body, and have a soul. So important for you to realize you are firstly a spirit made in the image of God. You have a soul, mind, will, intellect, emotions, but you are in a body.
Yep.
And that body takes you places. That body takes you places. Wherever you go, your body goes, I promise you.
Yeah. So you might have had things done to you, like an accident. You might have had done silly things yourself or whatever. You know,
Doesn't matter.
We've got to forgive ourselves. And you know what? When we take it all to the God and say, God, I hand it over to you. Begin to pray in the Holy Ghost. I'm not just talking shandaradadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadadad
understand what you're doing. So, Holy Spirit, I need you now to pray through me the mystery, the perfect plan. And on purpose, meaningfully engage.
Yeah.
Engage as you and I are talking.
Yep.
So when you engage, hala bakese ke lo bose, be mindful. Not see, I used to hala but I'd be thinking about my lamb roast while I was praying.
Yeah.
I don't think you can do that. You need to pray on purpose.
Yeah.
And that's respectful. He's the Holy Spirit. He needs your attention, your time, because he's trying to get something to you.
Yeah.
You've got to pay attention.
Yeah.
And it's so beautiful because as you hala bakese, you might get the understanding, not always,
yeah.
but you may. And one little story, I was just praying one night, 11:30 at night, nearly midnight. Hala bakese, just praying at home. All of a sudden, he spoke, go to King's Park. Go to King's Park, it's midnight. Anyway, I got in my car, drove to King's Park, drove there, parked. And when I got there was a young man sitting, just having a cigarette and with his dog. But I knew I was there for him.
Yeah.
And I just sat there and he was smoking. I got out of the car, just sat near him. This is midnight now. He walks past me, hops in his car. And I thought, I must have missed you, God. And God said, no, stay there. Stay praying. How do I know? But stay praying. And I just, just quietly. He came out of the car, walked straight up to me and he said, lady, what are you doing in the park? I said, I want to ask you a question. What are you doing in the park? And he said, do you really want to know? And I said, I think I do. And he said, well, I've come to kill myself. And I said, and I have come by the Spirit of God to find you, young man, to say how much God loves you. He knows exactly what you're planning to do. And I have come to tell you not to do it because he loves you. Well, he began to cry, Marika.
Mm.
18 years of age, I gave him a cuddle. He'd put an injection in his arm. He had the stuff in the car to take his life. But for the next 2 hours, we went down to a coffee shop. Coffee shops were open in those days in Subi. And I just sat with this young man and he said, God really sent you. God sent you for me.
Yeah.
And I said, yes. And I loved that. See, I didn't know anything, but yeah. I knew he wanted me to go.
It's beautiful.
And that's the wisdom. And people can have that happen in your own life. You can just be sitting in the lounge. Holy Spirit, what should I do? And he'll just say, get up.
Because he becomes our guide and our helper.
Yes.
When we ask him to come in and we begin to pray in the Holy Ghost, he becomes our guide and our helper. He leads us. Even yesterday, God says, be in the park at 3:00. A lady fell over. She hurt herself. Oh. She split her leg open. A dog came down the hill and bowled her over. And there was no one else in the park to help her. And because I live on the park, I went and got her tissues. I was able to help her leg. I prayed for her. And you know what? I was able to minister to her about Jesus and just share with her. She said, I'm atheist. But I said, that's all right. Jesus still loves you.
Yes,
His hands
course.
On your life. And he brought me here for this such a time as this to help you. And,
yes.
you know, I was able to help her get back on her feet and get her back home.
But isn't that lovely that you've got the boldness? And Marika's like me. I don't, it's not by chance. We're on divine assignments.
Exactly.
We are under the control of the Holy Spirit and we want him to possess us, to take us over.
Yeah.
And so we are not ashamed of that gospel. It's good news. And like you're saying to an atheist, no, God wants me to help you, love you. He loves you. You may not know him, but he knows you.
Yeah.
How powerful is that?
But when the Holy Spirit does, that is powerful. When the Holy Spirit comes in, he actually takes over.
Oh, awesome.
Spirit, soul and body. And he has his way. When we allow him to have his way, and you know what? He will lead you on little adventures. And life is so much more exciting with the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
And you know what? It brings such healing and health and, you know, gives you a strong immune system. There's so many things that the benefits to the Holy Spirit when we begin to engage and pray in the Holy Ghost.
And it's like in the upper room, they were gathered there, 120 of them. They entered those rooms as basically cowards. They were afraid. Jesus had left. They didn't know. But when they emerged from that upper room out into the streets of Jerusalem, they were changed. They were transformed.
Yeah.
Peter gets up and preaches a sermon. He was bold. It was an instant transformation. The Spirit of God had hit them and transformed them. And that's an ongoing process. But there should be change in people's lives. A spirit-filled life should show. There should be some evidence that he is in charge.
Yeah, it changes everything. And the Holy Spirit's unpredictable.
Oh.
We, as people, we try and put him in a box, but he is completely unpredictable. And I really believe that's the exciting part of moving with the Holy Spirit, because he can't, you know, we can't put him in a box, because he wants to do it one way and we want to do it another way, or we want to do it the same way. That's religion every time. But God's saying, hey, come on, let me move through you. Let me show you what I can do. Be at this place at this time and I'm going to move through you. I'm going to minister to this person. This person needs Jesus. And, you know, just like the shoe shop, I went in there the other day. God took us there. And, you know, I was able to pray for the lady. Her son was coming off heroin and, you know, she was in tears and she gave her heart to Jesus. And, you know, that's the Holy Spirit.
He's
breathed
leading
on them in the upper room.
Yes.
And he can breathe on your life today. You know, if you need healing, if you need whatever it is, you know, help with, you know, forgiving people. God can come and breathe on your situation. The wind came. Another word for the wind is the breath. The breath of God. And he comes and breathes on your situation and brings life, like I said at the start.
Sweeps.
God wants to bring life to every area of your life. And that's it. He wants to breathe his breath and come.
Let him.
Yeah.
I think we have to invite him every day. Holy Spirit, today, do what needs to be done in me. The way he's to help us reach the plan, fulfill the plan and purpose in our life. And God wants us as trophies of his grace, of his glory. He wants us to manifest the healing that he's promised, to manifest his peace, joy, love, all the fruit of the Spirit. What, you know, all those beautiful fruit, we are to exhibit those signs to a lost and a dying world.
Yeah.
To be light in their darkness and salt to their wounds.
Yeah.
Because that's in Acts 10:38, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power.
Yeah.
Who went about doing good and healing everyone who was oppressed of the devil.
Yeah.
What was the Holy Ghost sent to do? To manifest God's will.
Yeah.
Jesus went about healing all that were oppressed. He'll heal you today. Why would he heal? Covenant.
Yeah.
He wants you healed. Yeah. He wants you on his trophy wall.
Yeah.
I love that. You know, put it in the trophy room. He wants you in his trophy room.
Yeah.
He wants to say, see this one? They were sick, but now they're well. You know, there's a transformation, and I believe it's going to be increasing. This is not going to take a long, long time.
Yeah.
Can these bones live?
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
They can.
Very quickly. You are going to take on health far quicker than you can imagine.
Yeah.
I just
feel... Suddenly.
It's going to be a suddenly, you know, a mighty roar from heaven. And I just believe we're going to have amazing testimonies.
It says, come, four winds, breathe upon these slain that they may live, in Ezekiel 37.
Yes, yes.
And God's saying to you today, come, allow me to come into your life. I want to breathe on every situation and every circumstance and bring life and bring health and bring joy and bring peace. God's saying to you today, invite me into your home. Say, come, Holy Spirit, breathe your breath of life into this situation, into this circumstance, into whatever part of your body it is. God wants to come, and you just lay your hands on it and say, God, I declare life. I declare health. Father, I thank you. I prophesy to this situation that you are turning everything around for good. And as you begin to declare his word and speak life and prophesy, everything begins to change. It might not feel like the pain leaves like that. Sometimes it does. Sometimes I'll go, pain, leave my body in the name of Jesus, and it leaves like that. Other times it takes, you know, it takes a bit of time, and you've got to speak into it and declare it and stand your ground. And God's saying, don't quit. Don't give up. Stand your ground. Know that I'm the healer. Know that I'm your deliverer. Know that I'm bigger than your circumstance. Know that I am turning everything around for good when you trust in my word and allow the breath of God to come and breathe life into that situation. Because he just loves you so much.
Amen.
And he wants to pour his love out on you. And, you know, by asking the Holy Spirit to come into that situation, he's pouring his love out on you. He's pouring his life out on you. And you're never going to go without. You're never going to go without when you put your trust in him and you say, God, have your way in my life. And that's opening your heart up to God. And he just comes and he breathes life into you. He breathes life into that situation. And everything begins to shift and change when God comes in. And it's just like in the upper room. It was a suddenly. You know, in Genesis 2:7, it says, and the Lord God formed man of the dust of the ground and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life. And man became a living soul. That's that breath of life.
Alive.
It's all through the Bible there, right from the very beginning in Genesis. The Holy Spirit proceeds from the depths of God. This is why when, you know, partly the Holy Spirit came into them, into the, all the followers of Jesus, it was his breath that touched them. It was the wind of the Holy Spirit. And it's right from the very start, right into the book of Acts there, the breath of God.
In John, before Jesus left, he breathed on them and he said, receive the Holy Spirit.
Yeah, he did.
Because when you get born again, you don't necessarily, you're not necessarily baptized in the Holy Spirit at that time. You have received the conviction of the Holy Spirit of your sin, and then he convicts you of your righteousness. But then you come into a position where you invite, because you've been born again of the Spirit of God, your temple is now ready to receive the Holy Spirit of God. And he comes in and takes up residence. Yeah. And the sign he's there is tongues, definitely.
Yeah.
And I just love this, that he comes in and the breath. And it's no longer I that live. Galatians 2:20 says, but Christ lives in me. And the life I now live by faith in the Son of God. So really, every breath is precious.
Yeah.
Life is in you. And what sort of life? Jesus said, I've come to give you abundant life. Abundant life is not just getting by. I'm just getting by this week, Sally. You know, that's not the kind of life Jesus said, I've come to give you.
Yeah.
This is life.
Yeah.
Abundant.
Life more abundantly. I love that scripture you just said there, John 20:22. And it says, and when he said this, he breathed on them and he said to them, receive the Holy Spirit. And you know, it's that breath of God that God's wanting to breathe on us at this time. What an important Pentecost Sunday it is coming up this week.
This is going to be an awesome Pentecost. Something very special about this one. I don't know the full details, but I know it's linked to the Jewish calendar very closely.
Yep.
Scholars would know that more than I do.
Yeah.
But there's something in the realm of the Spirit. We must be sensing that. We know things. This is going to be such a pivotal time, especially since the church has been taken out for a time.
Yeah.
And we've been spending time in the presence of God. And we are going to return in the power of the Spirit.
Yeah.
That we haven't been wasting time.
Yeah.
We've been with our Lord. We've been, you know, like getting stronger, healthier, wiser, studying. I think it's just wonderful what's been happening.
Well,
and as we come out, I think we're going to come out different.
Yeah, we are. Well, I think people are coming out. They're coming out on fire.
Oh.
And the fire of God, you know, it burns on the inside of us. When we begin to pray in the Holy Ghost, Ooh. It is fire.
Ooh,
and, you
yes.
know, no sickness can stay when you're on fire for
Consuming
God. And you can
fire.
Begin to declare fire. Thank you, Father. The
yeah.
fire of God burns in me.
Yes.
Thank you, God. It burns anything that's not of you out of my yeah. body in Jesus'
yes.
name.
Because even in the natural, why do you have a fever? Why do you have a fever? Because it burns up the bugs.
Mm-hmm.
So in the spiritual,
yep.
why do you light that fire? It'll
yeah.
burn out anything, the wood, the hay, the dross, the stubble. I'm telling you, yeah, Holy Ghost fire.
The fire of God burns
it's
on the inside
fall.
Of us. Well, we're going to pray right now.
Thank you, Lord.
And I know this weekend Pastor Margaret's speaking on the Holy Ghost on Sunday morning.
Wow,
and then
awesome.
We have citywide prayer online.
Sunday night.
Sunday Ooh. Evening. And then I know it starts at about 4:30, 5 o'clock online.
Excellent. Oh, it's
And
be
I think
perfect.
It's partly to do with Sunshine Radio. And I think the start of our church service on Sunday night is going to be about prayer and Pentecost. So
excellent.
It's an exciting weekend that's
yeah,
coming up.
Get ready.
But we're just going to pray right now.
Thank you,
Father,
Lord.
I just thank you right now for anyone out there
thank
listening,
you,
Father. I
yes,
thank you
Lord.
That you just touch them with your power and with your fire right now, Father.
Yes,
I thank
Lord.
You any sickness, disease, infirmity has to leave right now in the name of Jesus, that your healing power yeah. flows through their body and makes alive their mortal flesh. Father, I command headaches and migraines to leave right now in Jesus' name. Father, I speak peace to their minds right now. Father, I thank you that your healing power flows through their kidneys, liver, heart, lungs, every organ
every
in their
part
bodies,
of their body.
Through their joints, Father, that it's your healing power bringing life and health, Father.
Yes,
I just
Lord.
Thank you right now, Lord Jesus, that your people are washed in the blood of Jesus and no weapon formed against them shall prosper. And I just speak to that person with that neck pain, every joint in their neck, Father, I just command it to come into alignment right now in Jesus' name. And we speak life to their necks, Father. I just thank you right now, your life flowing through their spine, through their necks right now, Lord
yes,
Jesus.
Lord.
I just thank you for the power and the blood of Jesus washing over their necks and spine. Father, I thank you that you are their healer, you're their deliverer. Father, we just thank you. Pour your spirit out right now on
yes,
every person
Lord.
Listening. Father, I thank
whatever
you that you just
the need,
pour
Lord.
It out. Pour
whatever
it out, Lord
Whatever the
Jesus.
Need, Lord. We just thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Someone with the right arm, I feel like you can't you almost move it. I just say to you, move it in the name
thank
of
you,
Jesus,
Jesus
Christ of Nazareth. Move that arm. Move. Stretch out that arm. Father, we just thank you today for anyone that suffering, it's immobility. You actually can't move very much. And if you do move, you have pain. Well, I just encourage you that to say, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Step out in faith. Just step up, step out. Put your foot in the water, so to speak. And I really believe you're going to see fire. You're going to feel fire on your body. You're going to almost like you think, someone call the fire truck. Because it's going to be such a consuming fire. And it's like God is going to turn up. And Father, we just thank you that we see people being able to run and walk, move their limbs, move their arms, knees, arms, every part of their body functioning the way God designed you to function. Nothing missing, nothing broken. Shalom. Speak shalom to everybody. Shalom in Jesus' name.
Thank you, Jesus. Father, I just thank you, Lord Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Lord, for eyesight right now, Lord Jesus, that people have 20/20 vision.
Y'all have that, Marie.
Lord
yes,
Jesus,
thank
in
you,
these
Lord.
Last days, Father, I thank you, Lord Jesus, that you're just pouring your spirit out and you pour your spirit out on every person's eyes listening right now, Father. Lord, that there is no distance in the spirit, Father. And I thank you for all the testimonies that we've had, but Father, I thank you for more testimonies,
send them
Lord
in.
Jesus. Send them, yes, send in your testimonies.
We
Father,
need
I thank you,
thank you
eyesight. Lord.
Lord,
their eyes be open to see right now in Jesus' name. I just thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, that you're restoring people's eyesight, regenerating the
yes,
cells
Lord.
In their eyes in Jesus'
Amen.
Name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. You know, if you're out there and you don't know Jesus, you know, we've just talked about the Holy Spirit. We've talked about Him pouring His Spirit out in these last days. Well, He wants to pour His Spirit out on everyone. And He wants everyone to know His love and His presence and His power. And if that's you and you don't know Jesus and you don't know Him as your personal Lord and Savior, it's a simple prayer to ask Him into your heart today. And if you say this prayer after me, dear Jesus, I believe in You.
I believe in
I believe that You're my Lord and my Savior.
I believe You're my Lord and my Savior.
I believe You died on the cross.
I believe You died on the cross.
And You rose again.
And You rose again.
And I'll follow You.
And I'll follow You.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
You know that simple prayer, you ask Jesus into your
Amen.
Heart.
Thank
He'll
you,
be
Lord.
With you all the time, every step of the day, everywhere you go. Jesus is with you. He's on the inside of you.
By
you can
the
talk
Holy
to Him.
Spirit.
Yeah,
that's
you can
how
talk
He's
to
with
Him.
You, by the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
Jesus, you know, like people say, well, how can Jesus be with me? He's in heaven. No, He's with you by the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
And they're one and the same in the Father.
So
He'll never leave them. He'll never forsake them.
Yeah,
so
we talked about
beautiful.
One part of the Trinity.
Yes,
the Father, the Son, and
the
Holy
Ghost.
Spirit.
They're
well, today,
all one.
You ask Jesus into your heart. You ask the Holy Spirit. He comes to live on the inside of you, and He's with you
always.
You can communicate with Him every single moment of the day. And you know, when you begin to pray in the Holy Ghost, you tap into the Spirit of God and He begins to talk to you and you can hear His voice and He'll lead you and He'll guide you. You know, if you want to know more about Jesus and the prayer you just prayed, we'll send you a little book. Just write in to us, send us an email, any testimonies of healing. We would love to hear them. We've got some coming up next week and the week after, testimonies
yes.
of people that have been healed, and even a lady, her whole business has been turned around while she began to watch this program. God touched her and gave her the wisdom, and it completely turned around, and God's done a great restoration
Amen.
In her business and in her
it's
life
wonderful.
Through hearing this program. And I just know, Barb, as we continue to pray together and stand in unity across our city and our nation, God is pouring His Spirit out, and we're excited that this Pentecost Sunday,
this
as our
one.
Church comes together and
Special.
Prays with the rest of the city, I know people's lives are going to be touched and changed, and be expectant.
Yeah, say something special is going to happen to me.
Yeah.
God will meet that expectation.
He does, doesn't He?
He turns up.
Get excited.
Oh, it's going to be a great Sunday.
Yeah, have that expectancy.
There's
that this is my
good.
Sunday. This
yes.
is my Sunday, Father. Just like they happened in Pentecost in the upper room, they had a suddenly. God, I expect a suddenly in my life. I expect a suddenly in my family, in my children, and just have that expectation
finances,
because God can do it like
whatever.
That.
Whatever.
Yeah.
There's going to come suddenlies.
Oh, I love that lady's testimony. You're going
yes.
to hear it next week. Within
yes.
5 days, she was going to have to shut her business down, and God turned it all around.
Just like that.
Yep.
Suddenly.
Suddenly. He did a suddenly.
Suddenly.
If He did it for her, He can do it for you.
Absolutely.
Have an awesome week. We love you. Oh, if you want to give online, you are more than welcome. It is our midweek service. You can give online because God wants you blessed. Just like He touched that woman's business, He can touch your life and your business and turn it all around.
Yes.
And you know, as you give, it is pressed down, shaken together, running over. Be expectant of increase and blessing. Be expectant for change, and God turns everything around for good when you give and you put your trust in Him. So you can give online. Have an awesome week. We love you, and see you later.
See you later.